She sure has, Linda. Yesterday in semifinals, she beat Julie Hallard from France, and it was just an easy, easy match. She's only lost 10 games coming into this final, and playing Julie Hallard in the semis would usually be a first-round match for Steffi.
And here come the players, Monica Seles, followed by Steffi Graf, now the number two-ranked player in the world, eager to get a victory under her belt today and a first title of the year. We'll be back with live coverage of this final round match after this. Warming up at the net there against Monica Seles in this their first meeting on hard courts. Both quite familiar with this court, of course. Steffi won this tournament in 88 and 89. Monica won it last year. And she's the defending champion and the youngest player ever to hold the number one world ranking. 17 years old, Monica Seles. There's Steffi Graf. Of course, she was number one in the world for 186 weeks, a record in both men and women's tennis, and she's looking to make a hat trick here. She's won the title twice before, and this, if she wins today, would be her first title of the year. She's really hungry for a title win this year.
She sure is. She hasn't won the last five tournaments. She needs to get that confidence back up.
Monica Seles, of course, very confident. She's won a couple of tournaments already this year. She now lives in Florida, but she started out life, of course, in Yugoslavia. She still plays for Yugoslavia. Steffi Graf there, 21 years old now, born in Brule, a place that is producing one player after another, an area where Boris Becker came from, an area where the new Anke Huber, the new West Germans coming out of, a very successful program down there in South Germany.
Both of these girls have homes in Florida, so they don't have to travel all the way back to Europe in between their tournaments.
Now we'll take a look now at how these players reach the final.
Okay, Monica had an easy time beating Labatt and Porwick. Claudia Porwick is a very good player in DeLone. And she had the first tough match yesterday where she beat Manuela Maleva in three sets.
So Monica Seles really only been tested once so far in this tournament by Manuela Maleva-Franier in the semifinals yesterday when she was taken to three sets. Steffi Graf, however, really hasn't been tested at all this week, has she, Tracy? She is just whipping her way through everybody.
Like she's just having a warm-up week. She beat Audra Keller 2-1, and Javer, and Susan Sloan, another girl from Kentucky, and Julie Hallard from France yesterday.
So no real challenge yet, but a different story today, and both players said they will have to raise their games today. They will be much more motivated, much more psyched up, taking on each other in this match. So Steffi Graf serving, first game. Right away there, Monica Seles really jumping on that return. She seems to take the serve very early, Tracy.
Yes, she does. Usually both players in the first game kind of play more tentative, have the nerves, try and get the feel, the range of the court.
No.
Little bit of a shaky start there for Steffi Graf. They have played each other before, of course, although never on a hard court, and Graf leads the series 3-2, but a few surprising results in there.
Graf won the first three, and Monica has won the last two.
Shot that Steffi Graf wants to hit. She's having a little bit of trouble on her serve, but her forehand seems to be on form.
Thank you. Monica's favorite shot. She loved that backhand. That's her big weapon. Steffi doesn't have enough on this shot. Monica leans into that shot, twists her whole body into it.
So it's double break point against the serve of Steffi Graf.
Steffi hasn't been broken all week.
Booming return there for Monica Seles gives her a break in the first game to lead one love. Game. Shaky start there, Tracy, for Steffi Graf. Is there any reason why she may have been a little bit nervous? She's used to being the number one seed, the number one player. This is the first time she's had to face the number one player in the world against her for 3.5 years.
Yeah, I don't think she'd be any more nervous because of that. She usually starts out so well, but, you know, she goes for her shots, and it just takes a while to get that range.
So Monica Seles, 30-love in this game. Steffi Graf yet to find her rhythm in the match. 40 love for Monica Seles, and what a tremendous year she had in 1990, Tracy. She just went every place winning 6 consecutive titles, 9 overall. And a love game there for Seles. Can she repeat that kind of a feat this year, do you think?
You know, she says she doesn't want to think about that because then that puts pressure on her, and it would really be such a feat because all the girls are so close now. And everybody's playing so well.
If she wins here today, Monica Seles is on her way to doing that. The first title she won last year was the Lipton Championships in Key Biscayne. This was the second title last year, and she's in the final again, of course, with another chance.
Last year, it went all the way through the French Open, where she won her first Grand Slam, and her streak finally ended in the quarterfinals of Wimbledon. She lost to Zina Garrison.
Steffi Graf loves to hit that forehand.
People have been saying that Steffi needs to add more to her game. But she says, no, I just need that big forehand. Big forehand and big serve.
So Steffi Graf looking quite a bit more confident now in this game. She lost her first service game, but she's 40 love up. A love game for Steffi Graf. We'll be back with more live coverage after this. The set of the U.S. Women's Hard Court Championships, the final match. Steffi Graf complaining there about that weak return.
It's going to be important for Monica to get her first serve in. She's lost her serve 7 times this week. And when she gets her first serve in, she wins 73% of the points. And when she doesn't, she only wins 44. Because her second serve is a lot weaker than her first.
Thank you.
mistake there. Steffi had Monica running backwards. The rule is that whenever you see the player that you're playing back, that you move into the net. When Monica lobbed that high ball, Steffi should have come in and taken it out of the air. She lost her offensive position by letting the ball bounce and letting Monica back into the point.
Said during the Lipton tournament that she didn't really believe in herself again. She wasn't hitting the forehand like she likes to hit it.
Now, this forehand was set up by those wonderful slices that Steffi hits low into Monica's forehand. Those are tough for her to get down on with that two-handed shot.
40-30. Could confidence be a factor for Steffi Graf now? She hasn't been winning titles, and she is ranked number 2 for the first time. Do you think that's a factor for her?
Yeah, I think it would have to be because, you know, she's lost a few tough three-set matches and, you know, you start to doubt yourself a little bit more, whereas in so many of the previous years, she just won everything and played a lot on confidence.
Graf is running around her backhand and hitting that forehand with a lot of confidence. Really challenging Monica Seles here in a battle at the baseline.
One thing that happens as well is the other players start to believe that they have a chance to beat Steffi, whereas before she seemed almost invincible.
Monica Seles said that when Steffi became number one, everyone figured she'd be there for her entire career. No one expected this drop down to number 2, least of all Monica Seles. She herself is very surprised to be ranked number 1 this soon. And there it is, 3-1 Seles. So she holds on to that lead in that early break she got from Steffi Graf. But Graf, who got off to a bit of a shaky start in that first game, looking much more in control now.
She missed a few backhand returns in that game, and that's something that Steffi has had to try to work on in the past. That left-handed serve slicing wide into her backhand, she's had trouble with, starting back when playing Martina Navratilova.
Monica Seles, of course, hits two hands on both sides, a rare style. We don't see too much of that from good singles players, although it has been quite effective among some famous doubles players.
There you see Steffi has 8 unforced errors already. She is going for it. Monica's playing it more safe. She can't have that many unforced errors. Or if you do, you have to have an awful lot of winners as well.
There's another unforced error from Steffi Graf, and she is triple break point down in this game. Could give Monica Seles a 4-1 lead in this first set. Steffi Graf couldn't handle that low backhand. She dropped serves again to trail 1-4. So Monica Seles ahead 4-1, a surprising lead in this first set. We thought it might be a little closer.
Yes, and the 25 points played so far, Celis has only missed 4 shots. Would that last one make it 5?
Celis is so quick at the baseline. She gets to almost everything. What does Steffi Graf have to do to run her around some more and make winners?
Well, hit angles like this, where Monica has to actually take one hand off the racket. You know she's in trouble then. Steffi took that ball on the rise.
To Graf's forehand is not a good idea, is it?
Asking for disaster. You know, Monica has to be that much quicker because she has the double hands on both sides, and that she loses some range there.
So triple break point now. And there it is, a forehand return to break Monica Seles for the first time in this match. Graf edging back to 4-2 after trailing 4-1. Monica Seles became the youngest player to reach the number one ranking this year, beating out my partner here, Tracy Austin, by just half a month, Tracy.
I don't know if they calculated that right.
You better take a look at her birth certificate.
Just kidding. Are now trying to do against Monica. They feel that she runs well laterally, but she doesn't move in as well. So that's a smart shot by Steffi. Something that she's also trying to incorporate more into her game.
That's something that we saw yesterday with Manuela Maleva-Franier. She used the drop shot very effectively against Monica Seles. Unfortunately, she couldn't quite turn things around in the third set there, but that's really how she clinched the second set, and Steffi Graf taking a leaf out of that book today.
Steffi's really dominating the play and trying to force play here. Monica's just basically keeping it back, most time even down the middle.
And there's that big serve, so useful for Steffi Graf. That's definitely a weapon that Monica is yet to develop. This is a hard court, of course, quite fast here. It should favor probably Steffi Graf by a small margin. Closing the gap here on Monica Seles. Seles had a chance to lead 5-1 there, was leading 4-1, but now it's 4-3. Monica Seles serving. To wish all our viewers, of course, a happy Easter and a happy Passover. It's a beautiful day here in San Antonio. Brilliant sunshine, no wind, hardly any humidity. Ideal playing conditions for these two players. And certainly a great match unfolding here today.
That's a tactic that Yana Novotna used against Seles in the finals of the Australian Open, low to her forehand. I really think that if you can do it, it works. She can't get much on it.
The winner in that contest.
They sure used all sides of the court. It's amazing. During the point, you look at Monica, she has her whole weight into her body, and it seems like her grunt gets louder when she hits the backhand, whereas when she hits her forehand, she's usually leaning back.
In trouble. Two break points down. Steffi Graf has a chance here to even the set at 4-all after trailing 1-4 earlier.
This forehand, boy, did she hit it clean and well. Down the line, winner perfect. I think her forehand's getting warmed up.
Well, she looked in so much trouble earlier in this set. She dropped serve twice. What's changed around here for Steffi Graf?
Well, I think that she's just making contact a lot better. She's cut down on her unforced errors. She's won 12 of the last 15 points.
Just too many short balls there by Monica Seles. Steffi Graf taking full advantage on the forehand side.
Well, we talked about in the beginning that Steffi was really dominating and forcing the points, and that Monica was just basically getting the balls back in and not forcing it as much, and Steffi was making errors. And now they're going in. Second double fault.
Fortunately, not too serious a moment there to serve one by Steffi Graf. 15-all. Again, Steffi Graf really coming to net, Tracy.
Well, she didn't even have to make the volley because the coming in shot was so strong. Seems to be pumping herself up. There you see Steffi with 12 winners. Monica with only 3. But then again, Steffi is going for it more.
Steffi Graf making it look easy now with that big first serve, then finding the opening in the court.
Now, this is Steffi at her best when she has this huge, big serve working. Monica can just get it back, and then she has that other weapon of hers, that huge forehand, to make the winner.
And there it is, the game for Steffi Graf. She leads 5-4 now in this match. We'll be back after this. San Antonio Riders. In regional action, the Barcelona Dragons visit the Montreal Machine. Live action kicks off tomorrow at 8 p.m. Eastern, 5 Pacific, here on USA. So Monica Seles really must stop playing defensively and go on the attack to even this set.
Here's Steffi playing so aggressively, moving inside the court. Always looking to move forward. She's won 18 of the last 22 points. Really playing aggressive. There's a little change of tactics there. Monica trying her own slice shots.
Well, she presumably feels she must do something. She was up 4-1 now. She's facing potentially a loss of this first set.
It's her first double fault. But you know, Monica can't put Steffi in trouble with her serve like Steffi has been able to do in this match.
Well, that certainly came at a critical time, that double fault.
Two set point.
Monica Seles, as you mentioned, Tracy's played singles and doubles here all week. She had a tremendous 10 days at the Key Biscayne tournament. Could she be a little tired today in this final?
Well, I think she would be tired, but you know, she was at the basketball game last night, so she wasn't home resting.
Still set point. Steffi Graf missing her bread and butter shot there just when she needed it most, and it's deuce.
And it's so important to feel fit and to feel alive, especially for Monica, because she has such good footwork, and that's so important to her game, to have that good footwork, good balance. She feels a little bit sluggish, especially with a two-handed shot. She's not going to quite get there. Great point by Monica. I tell you, both of them played so well. But it was this shot right here. She gave it her all. She figured, hey, I'm out of the court. I'm going to give it all that I can. And then look at that terrific angle. So much power from those shots.
Steffi Graf saves the game point.
Well, Monica barely gets this. Most players would come in and take that out of the air. Steffi lets it bounce, and it works just fine. She puts that one away. tell you, Monica is such a fighter. She was down 2 set points. She just hangs in there. Tough. She makes it tough to win each and every point. She doesn't give you much of anything.
Certainly her confidence has been a factor all week and all year, really. Back to deuce. Both players playing the ball extremely deep, and Monica Seles unable to control it there on that last point. Steffi Graf.
Another forehand winner. She runs around that backhand, hits that winner. She loves that shot. She pumps herself up after that shot.
But she just didn't have the energy to chase that lob down, and it's set to Graf.
Monica did a lot of running this point, barely gets there, looking a little bit tired. Steffi flicks her wrist, puts the lob over, and Monica wishes that they were going to call that one out. I tell you, she did look tired this point.
So first set to Steffi Graf, 6-4, after trailing 4-1 earlier in this set. She's really taken command of this match.
I tell you, that's what's making women's tennis so exciting right now. Is, you know, Monica's taking over the number one, but Steffi's right there. And last year was the first time since 1981 that all the Grand Slams were won by a different person, actually in the women's and the men's. Very exciting time now.
Of course, we've seen Gabriella Sabatini come a tremendously long way. She's developed a serve and volley game, something no one expected her really to do, and she's guts it out, and it gave her the U.S. Open title last year. Jennifer Capriati, of course, coming up as well, another young challenger.
Sabatini has been the one that has beaten Steffi in 4 of her, out of her last 5 tournaments. So she's been a real thorn in Steffi's side. And it is because she has become such a complete player. And she's actually been the one that said Steffi needs to get that topspin backhand and come to the net more.
The winner there from Monica Seles. Steffi Graf has been saying that she's resisting that idea, having tried to develop a topspin backhand.
Well, on this one, Monica seems to decide that she needs a little bit more power on her forehand. She's going to go for it a little bit more.
Steffi Graf had been working on her net game and on the topspin backhand. Now she says she's going back to her old style, running around that backhand or slicing it. A lot of criticism going her way about her stubbornness to change her game.
Well, I was there when she played Sabatini and Boca in the finals there, and you know, she didn't take advantage of some of her great forehands. The ball would come up high in the air and she didn't come in and volley it, and the play started all over again, and Gabby was able to get back into the point. know, she has a great overhead, but I just don't think she feels comfortable up there at the net. She comes in, but doesn't come in far enough, leaves too much open court for that angle.
It's deuce. First game of the second set. You're just joining us. Graf was trailing 4-1 in that first set before she turned on the energy and the aggression to clinch it 6-4. And now it's advantage Graf, first game of the second set in this final of the U.S. Women's Hard Court Championships.
Game Graf.
So Graf holds on and leads one love in the second set. Monica Seles serving. Second game of this second set. Graf won the first game and the first set, leading 6-4, one love.
She's won the last six games, Steffi Graf has.
Monica Seles looking as if she's a bit more in control now. It seemed that she'd given Steffi Graf the edge there for a while with that run of straight games.
And she's trying to force the play more.
Well, the umpire there, Jane Tabor from Great Britain, overruling the call from the linesman. Looked wide from up here, but a very decisive call there from the umpire.
Deep. I mean, first her backhand was right near the baseline, and then Steffi's forehand was right near the baseline. Terrific depth.
Too good there for Monica Seles, and she holds on, evening the score here at 1-1.
In the first set stats, you see that it was really Graf trying to go for it. She had 16 winners, but 18 unforced errors. I think most of those unforced errors came when she was losing 4-1, and she changed that around. Monica was almost just a spectator. Steffi was deciding the points.
So Monica Seles knows now that she must go for everything on her shots. She can't afford to be tentative. She too must risk making some errors in order to make those crucial winners.
You know, she always talks about going for it. Monica said if she could take anything back, it would be that she didn't go for her shots more when she lost to Linda Ferrando in the U.S. Open. And when it gets tight, she always talks about going for it. Keep going for her shots. That's how she likes to play.
It's been a while, of course, since these two faced each other, their last meeting on clay in the French Open last year. So therefore, a little bit of a change up here for Monica Seles. She's not used to the kind of player Steffi Graf is here today, and Monica herself a much better player than 6 months ago.
And she's also bigger. She's a bit taller.
Yeah. getting stronger all the time. Both players move very well.
I don't think Steffi can get stronger. If anybody wants a footwork lesson, take a lesson from either one of these two. Their feet are constantly moving, constantly adjusting. Aggressive point for Monica. She comes in, and there's Steffi's footwork, always moving, always adjusting, always on her toes. Great footwork. One thing that is unusual about Steffi is that she jumps up in the air, you know, on her forehand. And most people don't teach that, but it sure works for Steffi. And every forehand, her body's jumping up.
On the serve also, she and Boris Becker seem to rise quite far off the ground. And you're right, when you're learning the game, you're taught that that's a no-no to jump when you're hitting the ball, but it seems to work for them.
And also her toss is quite high. They teach you not to toss it that high, but of course, Yvonne Lendl has a high toss like that. So I guess they're arguing with what's supposed to be. And it works for them.
It was very windy here early in the week, but no problems for Steffi on the toss. She just ripped through opponents until today's final. Steffi Graf holds on for a 2-1 lead in this set. More live action of this final when we come back. 15. We're back at the U.S. Women's Hard Court Championship. Monica Seles, the number one seed, taking on number two ranked Steffi Graf. Having a little bit of trouble here. She dropped the first set after leading 4-1. And Graf is ahead 2-1.
Monica serves kind of in the middle of the court, away from the tee, to try to get that angle to Steffi's back.
A little bit too much spin there on that second serve, and it's a double fault for Monica Seles.
Her second. There's her coach, Pavel Slazil, and on his right is Peter Graf, who just flew in today for this match.
A lot of people ask when Steffi Graf dropped down to number two in the world, well, would she replace her coach, Pavel Slozil? There's Peter Graf also watching. But she says no, she's staying with her coach, who's got her this far.
They seem to have a very close friendship as well. They get along quite well.
Now 3,000 people filling this stadium to capacity here at the McFarlane Tennis Center.
Stop. Now, even though Steffi didn't win this point, it's smart to hit it up high and give yourself a chance to get back into the point. But Monica's lob, or Monica's overhead, was too good. So hit it up as high as you can. Good play.
Game point here for Monica Seles. This is her first meeting with Steffi Graf since they switched rankings. Monica, of course, now number one in the world. Steffi Graf, number two.
Game
so Monica Seles holds on to stay even in this set.
Two games
all in the second set. Steffi Graf won the first set, 6-4.
And Monica has won their last two meetings. The last time that Steffi Graf won was in the Brighton tournament in 1989. Surprisingly, they haven't played that much, even though they're such top players. Setting up both of those points.
Steffi Graf cannot become number one again today, even if she wins this title. In fact, even if Monica Seles had lost in the first round here and Graf had won the tournament, she's still not quite close enough to overtake Monica yet.
Monica's number one on the craft points, and Steffi's number six. I don't think she's seen that number by her name in a long, long time. If she were to win here, she'd move up to number four.
Craft points, of course, build up to the Virginia Slims Championships at the end of the year.
The top 16 go there.
Tournament that Monica Seles won, beating Gabriella Sabatini in five sets. For Steffi Graf, it's break point. She's at 2-2 in this second set, having won the first. She'd like to hold on to the momentum here, but now Seles has a chance to break and lead 3-2.
So first break point in this set.
Was not going to let that point get away.
She hit that one out of the stadium. Steffi comes in. Watch how she doesn't let it go up too high. Hits it right on the rise. Moves in for that beautiful overhead. Bounces it outside of the court.
Back to deuce.
Because she moved all the way into her backhand corner, and she can hit it down the line or cross court just as easily. So it's like a 50-50 chance you get caught.
And an ace for Steffi Graf to give her a 3-2 lead in the second set. 15 here in the sixth game of the second set. Monica Seles in a little bit of trouble here. She had chances, but Graf is leading 3-2.
Oh.
If you're Monica Seles now, Tracy, what do you do to negate those winners from Steffi Graf?
Well, that's hard to do. I think one thing that you have to do is try to get more depth on your shot so that Steffi can't dominate as much. You know, when she starts to hit short, then Steffi can move in and pick which corner she wants to hit in. Easier said than done.
Short ball just feeding that forehand of Steffi Graf. She makes no mistake there with the winner.
There's winners. 28 winners for Steffi Graf, and 22 of those are forehand winners.
The crowd doesn't like it. The umpire called it. Steffi Graf is going to have words with Jane Tabor, the umpire.
Well, I think that the linesman didn't call it. The umpire overruled it.
There's the shot from Steffi Graf, called long by the umpire. Very difficult to see, of course, at that angle. But Steffi Graf still gets the break. She was at love 40 when that call came. She had a lot to say about it, but she was still in command there and breaks for a 4-2 lead in this second set. She won the first set 6-4 in this championship match of the U.S. Women's Hardcourt Championships here in San Antonio.
There's Esther and Caroli Seles, Monica's parents, who go everywhere with her. Big supporters.
Shot again. Caroli Seles, of course, the coach of Monica now. She used to work with Nick Bollettieri, but now her father is her only coach.
That last shot, I tell you, that was just confidence all the way. Monica hit quite a hard shot.
Steffi Graf gets confidence. She's really difficult to beat. She plays so aggressively, oozes out of her. You can see that she really believes she's going to win. That must be intimidating.
She starts to walk faster. She just looks so confident. Oh.
Seles really needs to do that more often. Jump on the ball early.
Boy, is she moving well. She is all over the court, all over the ball. She's playing so aggressive. That good serve set this up. Look where Steffi is. She likes that forehand. Moves across the net, so smooth, so fluid, and puts that volley away.
So 40-15 here.
Seems like in the last two games, her confidence level has just picked up a lot.
40-30. Steffi really feels she's back on her form this week. She's won very convincingly every round here and feels confident about her game. She lacked that a little bit last year.
I think this is the true test, though, because all week she really hasn't had to play anybody that tough. And coming in and playing against Monica, who's now number one in the world, this is the true test. This is the test right here, because you can never count Monica Seles out. She is such a tough fighter. It's her second ace, and it couldn't come at a better time. Boy, does she reach up well for this serve. Everything's going forward.
Four. 1 point away, Steffi Graf, from taking a 5-2 lead in this set. Will be trying to stay in this match. Celis on the ropes against Steffi Graf. She's the number one player in the world, Monica Celis, but she's trailing in this match. 6-4, 5-2 down in this set. But it's 15 love. Monica Seles, she is going to make Graf win this from her. She is not letting up in the aggression department. Have to remember that Seles was way down in that match with Sabatini and Kibiskain. Came back from a 4-love, 40-love deficit in the second set to beat Sabatini, so you can definitely say that Seles is never out of a set. Graf loves to run around that backhand, even on the return of serve there. It's 40-15. Well, Monica Seles knew she was beaten in that point. She was just rooted there at the baseline in the right-hand court as Graf hit the winner. Again, a short ball gave Graf the opportunity to control the point.
Game Seles.
But there it is, the second ace for Monica Seles. She stays alive in this match. It's 5-3 Graf. Graf now serving to win her first title of this year if she does it here at the U.S. Women's Hardcourt Championships. She had herself in all sorts of trouble when she could have put the ball away against Steffi Graf early on. She chose to go back to the forehand. The point continued, but the net saved her. Love 15. $45,000 goes to the winner here. $20,200 to the runner-up. But there's more important things than money at stake here today for these two players. Coming up here for Steffi Graf. She takes her time. Usually she's in such a hurry, she's right back at that line ready to serve. Now she's pacing herself. Pavel Slozil, her coach, Peter Graf, her father, watching on anxiously. Big serve from Steffi Graf. Even the score at 30-all. Tracy Austin now down at courtside waiting to interview the winner of this match. Steffi Graf hopes it will be her in the next 2 points. Monica Seles a chance to break here and get a little closer. Break point. Monica Seles would like to get back to 5-4 and have a chance to even this set. Once more, did not move for it. She knew where Steffi Graf was going to put it. And it's deuce.
Thank you.
Big crowd here today. Packed house of 3,000 people. Monica Seles, as Graf took advantage of it, and she reaches match point for the first time. Steffi Graf poised to win her first title of the year here. Monica Seles, of course, the number one ranked player in the world, facing match point down. Going for the ace there, Steffi Graf. But she didn't make it. And there it is, the forehand cross-court winner and the victory salute from Steffi Graf as she beats Monica Seles 6-4, 6-3. The crowd are on their feet. Steffi Graf just hangs her head in the towel with relief. A lot of emotion there for that young lady. She hasn't won a title since last November. But here it is today. The championship at the USTA Women's Hard Courts in San Antonio, Texas. So a very happy Steffi Graf wins her first title of the year. We'll be back. With her first title of the year, beats Monica Seles 6-4, 6-3. Let's go to courtside with Tracy Austin, who's standing by with the winner, Steffi Graf.
Great match, Steffi. Kind of started out a little bit slow. What changed?
Yeah, I guess in the beginning I was a little bit tired and I didn't feel too comfortable and I needed a few games to get in. And from then on, I just felt really great.
Gosh, it looks like your confidence is totally back. How do you feel?
I felt great on the court. I went for my forehands, I went for my shots, and I enjoyed it so much.
Did it have anything, Monica being number one and you two, did you feel any different down there?
Not at all. When you get into the match, you really concentrate on what's going on in that specific moment, so you really don't think about it. And you just go out and try your best.
You seemed really excited at the end. How do you feel?
Great.
Great match, Steffi. Back to you, Linda.
Thank you. Thank you, Tracy, and a very happy winner there, Steffi Graf, her first title of the year.
Monica, on behalf of the United States Tennis Association, it's my pleasure to present to you this check for the runner-up for the U.S. Women's Hard Court Championships. Congratulations to you.
I would like to thank all my fans here who've been supporting me last year and this year too. This year I didn't have as much as luck as I had last year, but I'm coming back next year. I hope I can do better than I did this year. I always have a great time in San Antonio, and this time was the same. And I just met so many friends back here who are cheering for me too. And I'm going to see you all back here next year. I would like to thank United States Tennis Association, Michael Burns, Joanne Sella for making it possible for this tournament, and then Kraft General Foods World Tour for sponsoring Women's Tour. And also I think I would like to thank the Ball Kids who've been great friends of mine this week, and everybody basically. Thank you very much.
Now let's give the winner's check to Steffi Graf.
Steffi, that was just a tremendous match, and the U.S. Women's Hard Courts, we're pleased to have had you here and hope to have you back many more times. Congratulations. And emblematic of the championship, here is this trophy for you.
It just feels great to be back, and I've had a couple of rough months, and to win that championship here, I decided very late to come here, but I should have done it earlier. Anyway, it felt just great to be back. I also want to thank all the sponsors, Kraft General Foods. I want to thank USDA and everybody really who was involved in the tournament. I think you made the choice easy for me to come back, and definitely next year, I don't have to think twice about it. I really want to also thank you for coming out here. I think it has been such great crowds and great weather this year compared to 2 years ago when it was always snowing. So it's a nice difference. And you've been all really great here. I really felt the Spurs can really be very, very lucky to have Dutch fans. The Spurs, honestly. Okay, thank you very much.
Thanks, Steffi. It was a great match. What a treat. Thanks a lot. Back to you, Linda.
Thanks, Tracy. A wonderful day of tennis here with Steffi Graf winning her first tournament of 1991.